just left him out of the poster. Oh, wait. I really hope they don't make Luke evil in episode 7. They left him out of the poster and trailer because he's not going to play a big part. Oh, really? I did see the posters, and I did notice that he wasn't there. I also wonder, because I talked to Eric about it, well, just in passing, but the posters all have a weapon over the character's right eye, and then I was thinking, like, the only one that it doesn't do that for is Carrie Fisher. Instead, it's like some weird halo thing. There's code for Legion in the earlier levels of 2, so Legion could have been unlocked earlier, but they changed it for some reason. It's probably because you're supposed to get Tali first, right? I don't know, we get our second dossier, or second set of dossiers after we recruit everyone here, I think. But that is interesting, Polly. I did not know that. There would be a lot of people wanting to use the Force and be seeking out the only person they know who's trained to use it. Do you think that it'll have Han Solo and Leia's children in it? I think she's going to be a commander in the Rebellion. We can finally go to the med lab. Or the tech lab, I guess. Don't need that yet. Metagel capacity, we will research. Assault rifle damage. Saeed uses an assault rifle. We'll be probing planets too, so. I might want this. Yeah, because I want to go get Archangel. Archangel! You're beautiful. Yeah, the young stormtrooper seems... I mean, he's supposed to be a clone, so obviously the clones are the stormtroopers, but the stormtrooper seems like he had powers. He was using a lightsaber, right? Or can anyone use a lightsaber? Kylo could be Luke's or Leia's son. To fulfill our destiny to Vader's helmet in the international trailer, potentially meaning he's Gramps. Kylo's the new bad guy, right? Yes! Yes, Luna, yes! I need to look more into those. Like I said, I need to watch the movies again, but then I also need to look up the trailers, apparently.
Shepard. How can I help?
Any ideas on other ways to prepare for the collectors?
Ideas, yes. Expensive, but possibly valuable. Can show you.
Thanks. Morden's Omni-Tool. Morden gets plus 20% tech power damage. Morden built his own Omni-Tool and can make significant upgrades given the proper materials. It's only 2700 element zero. Element zero is the hardest element to find, but I know that there's a few planets out there that you can probe that have quite a bit. Lots of little upgrades here. There was a rumor a while back that Lando might have a daughter who's in the movie. You think it's just speculation? I mean, they could bring Lando back. Or a daughter. You don't think he's a clone because in Star Wars Rebels, which is canon, it seems like the Empire is recruiting. Well, doesn't Luke have children with Mara Jade? So, if Mara Jade isn't in the series, how is Luke gonna have children?
Commander, can I help you with something?
Any thoughts on how to prepare against the Collectors?
They spec this ship to the original Normandy, but you were there. The Collectors cut her like butter. This armor just isn't top of the line anymore. People will die if we don't upgrade. Alliance had some new toys in secret dev before I left. I could try and pull a few favors.
Normandy represents the cutting edge of Cerberus fleet technology. Discover possible enhancements. Oh no! Palladium! Heavy ship armor. Requires 6,500 more palladium. Okay, at least we get it. You want to make sure that when you go through Mass Effect 2, before you go to the suicide mission, you want to get all of the upgrades from your squad members.
How we doing, Jacob? What's your sense of the mission?
If Morden's modifications hold up, we've got a shot. If they don't, we're dead. Seems like that was always a strong possibility, though. Anything else, Commander?
Yes.
What do you think of the state of the crew?
We don't have a full complement. We don't stand a chance without the right specialists on side. Anything else, Commander?
I'm more interested in just talking for a bit.
Sounds good. Have to say you run this ship tight, and we're getting things done. We keep on track, and maybe we'll figure this out. I hope so. I'm not looking forward to the debrief if it all goes to hell. Is there something specific, or are you just checking in?
My ship, my time. I just want to talk.
Informal, huh? Everything's in my file. Ex-Alliance like you, no Reapers or anything, but I got swept under the rug, too. The more good you do, the less they want to admit that something needed doing.
If you guys look up Mr. Sunday Movies on YouTube, he explains a lot of the new Star Wars stuff. It has a lot of theories. Yeah, Han and Leia have twins and another child. Luke and Mara have a child whom they named Ben. What they're not showing us in the trailers is actually a musical centered around Jar Jar. Spoilers, man! You gotta shh. Shh. Shh.
I can already see they lost a fine soldier, Jacob.
That's not how the Alliance sees it. Hell, they did the same to you. General public never knew you were dead, or heard the real story of the Citadel. Did you know they used you on recruitment ads? You were the human ideal for like 6 months. Then they replaced you with a composite image they invented. Guess you didn't focus test right. Perfect example of humanity, and they still dumped you.
So dumb how the Force Unleashed isn't canon. Yeah, none of the expanded universe is canon, is it? Baby, such wonderful plot devices. Right, Luna? It'll be interesting to see how many years after episode 6 this episode starts.
You liked what you saw, Mr. Taylor?
Ooh.
I meant that you were an example of what we can do, Shepard. Commander. I don't want this to get weird. I should get back to my duties. Everything has to be perfect if we're going to survive this.
I make you nervous. No, I can't say that, because we can't romance him.
All right, Jacob. Back to your duties.
Commander?
Shepard? Commander? I forgot to talk to Morden. 30 years?
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Of course. Plague on Omega dealt with. Plenty of time to analyze Collector intelligence. Impressive laboratory setup. Missed working for operations with the budget. AI in particular. Very helpful. Best setup I've seen since work with Special Tasks Group.
Middle age, Simmer. Harrison Ford is like in his 80s. But he does look pretty young for his age. They're in their 50s or 60s. They're not youngins anymore. I don't think that's Morden sings yet, though.
Is your assistant Daniel settling in all right?
Quite well. Safe and secure. Neighborhood mostly quiet with plague gone. Left him the security mechs just in case. Can't be too careful. Also tired of mechs. Noisy. Never used them in STG.
You said you were in the special tasks group. What kind of research were you doing?
Not simply research.
He's like 80. He's like 70.
High risk. Served under young captain named Kirihi. Studied Krogan genophage, took water, tissue samples from Krogan colonies.
Yeah, Kirihi. Kirihi was on Viramire. He led the special team there that got Kaden killed.
I worked with an STG captain named Kirihi. His team helped me destroy Saren's cloning facility on Burmire.
Heard he was part of that. Jury-rigged explosive. Always got job done with limited resources. Good captain. Bit of a cloaca, though. Loved his speeches. Hold the line. Personally prefer to get job done and go home. Probably military
hold
bravado.
Hold the line.
Dark and chest-pounding. No offense.
He's now called Han Solo. His balls are so low. Simmer. Facepalm. 70 and just recently has been trying to break all his bones. Did he break his ball? What the freak is going on here? I think that there's a cat hair stuck on my ring. 73.
What can you tell me about the genophage?
Bioweapon designed by Salarian science team. Deployed by Turians against Krogans to end Krogan rebellions more than 1,000 years ago. Affects every cell of Krogan body. Commonly and incorrectly considered a sterility plague. Actually adjusts viable fertility rates to compensate for high Krogan birth rate. Stabilizes to pre-industrial population growth levels.
Why would STG study the genophage?
Krogan rebellion's bloody. Dangerous. Nearly as bad as Rachni attacks. All species evolve, adapt, mutate. If genophage weakens, need to be prepared.
I remember that his plane crashed. Because he's a pilot. Yep, I remember that. And he broke his ankle. Carrie Fisher's 59. Mark Hamill 64. Harrison Ford 673. Holy crap. So wait, she was... How old was she? 22? Or... Was she still a teenager when she was in the first A New Hope? So, there's 14 years between her and Harrison Ford. Could you imagine that? Like, even if you're, say you're just 20, making out with, like, a mid-30s dude? Damn, he's sexy. Tripped on the Millennium Falcon... Or a door or something on set. What? Jeez.
What was the STG preparing to do?
Military schematics for likely Krogan population growth. Political scenarios for attack points. Genophage reduced Krogan numbers. Species aggression unchecked. Population explosion would be disastrous. STG helped check Krogan rebellions. Needed to be ready to do the same. Simple recon. Nothing to worry about.
Come out with it, sir. Ooh. Ooh. Do we look... We kind of look similar. A little. I noticed that male Shep, his scar goes way up. But also, we might not be fully unlocked. Well, can you see it all? I don't know. My hair's in the way. Harrison Ford was and still is pretty hot. Dude.
Nice talking with you, Morden.
Should get back to work. Need to study. So much data. Here if you need me.
Okay, Morden. Oh, we don't need to go that way. She was 21 when shooting Star Wars. I knew she was pretty young. Pretty dang young. Blah, 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 blah. We're not gonna speak with Kelly yet.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Holy cannoli. I think we've gone. I did further investigation. Okay, so this is the facial scarring. Negative attitudes and aggressive acts create adverse reactions with your cybernetic implants, while peaceful thoughts and compassionate actions promote healing. If you maintain a positive outlook, I believe your facial scarring will heal on its own. Otherwise, there is surgical equipment we could use to insulate your cybernetic implants and accelerate your healing regardless of your mental outlook. So normally what I do is that I play Super Renegade, and then before I go to the suicide mission, I heal all of her scars. Because I think... Maybe they transfer over? I don't remember. You still think Sean Connery is looking good? Before his retirement for movies. Like in The Rock? Mark Hamill looks like a space hobo. He does. You think after a while Kelly would just be like, message. You've received a new message as your private terminal, Commander. Luke Starkiller. Message from Anderson. On the off chance that the rumors are true and you are actually alive. Well, dude, okay, so there isn't any new messages. Woman. Like, I know he wants to meet up with us. Deal struck with Zaid. Lost contact with survey ship. Project Firewalker. That's where we get the hammerhead. Normandy crash site. This is actually, like, really nostalgic, this crash site. Still 20 crew members unaccounted for from the attack on the Normandy. Okay, so maybe we'll do that soon. Once we leave Omega, we're gonna go after Archangel. Non-dan subs! Nope. I subbed to no man. Dude, I freaking love Dan. I watched so much Dan during Horror Month. Just women. Arc projector. Cerberus assault armor. Oh, I think that we already looked at that. Rendezvous with Kasumi Godo. See, Kasumi is a character that I have not played with. So, she'll be new to me. Travel to the Sekira Ward on the Citadel. Okay, everything is good. Medbay upgrade. I thought I already did that. I like how the door is open and I don't have to touch it. Medbay upgrade. More platinum. Wait, missile launcher? That's all of our iridium. I don't think I can do that. Maybe. I will never say. Oh my gosh, this nose is... I'm sorry. Maybe I have a cat ear stuck there.
Commander.
So, how do you think we're doing?
Well, the Normandy's not as ready as she could be. There's always more we could upgrade. As for the crew, you'd have to ask him. People person.
You fly the Normandy.
What do you think about the people we're picking up?
Well, about the ones you went out with last, I would never say anything against Miranda and expect to survive the reprisal. Zaid is like you, but takes checks. As long as it's not my money, we're good. It's just my opinion, though. There's really no need to go spreading it around.
Touch controls, spread germs, motion sensors for the win! I love the doors.
Ever think about the old Normandy and the trouble we got up to?
Yeah, those seem like the good old days now, but come on, it was hell at the time. Geth, Saren, Sovereign, and then we got dumped. We're stuck in a weird place, sure, but back then it wasn't all sunshine and bunnies.
Surprise myself. There are cheats to get more resources and credits.
What happened to the rest of the old crew? I heard most survived.
Almost did. Presley didn't. The rest of us just sort of drifted apart. The Alliance didn't care. I don't think they liked all the non-humans in your crew. We were your team, Commander. With the Normandy destroyed and you gone, there wasn't much keeping us together.
Wow, that's horrible. Freaking Alliance. That's retarded. I'm hurt. Like, my crew was probably the best out there in the Alliance, and they just let them all drift apart. Cats will get in your face whether you like it or not. Yeah, mine's sitting right over there by the light. They have no respect for personal space.
I assume everything's going well up here?
I really want a chance to put the Normandy through her paces. I just have to trim up the drive output and it'll be like we never lost her.
Safety standards advise against manipulating drive settings while engines are powered and in use, Mr. Moreau.
Commander, can we shut this thing off? I don't need it in my day-to-day.
If you don't want to hear it, turn the damn sound off.
Well, it doesn't change anything. It's still watching. Like some creepy kid staring at the back of your head in comp sci. You just want to punch him, but he's special and he sets fires or something. Okay, a little too far there, but you know what I mean.
Your problem, not mine.
Sure.
Thanks. I'll remember this.
Hey, Wolfgang, how are you? I think I just fell in love with your femship. Riv, my femship is totally lovable. Totally.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
If you like seeing cats' butts up close, look at streams. Yeah, man streams. Did you see my tweet, Jones? So, yesterday I was watching man play Bloodborne, and Martin kept getting up in his lap and up on top of him. He ended up sitting on his desk right in front of the camera, and you could only see this much of man because Martin was sitting right in front of him staring at him.
Yeah,
I tweeted the picture out. It was hilarious.
Sometimes I press one.
Corgis and their little butt wiggles. Their little tubbies. Brody has a little stubby. I mean, he probably doesn't wiggle as much as a corgi. But that's really adorable. They're like 1 foot off the ground and their fur gets everywhere. Oh yeah, they got really thick fur, don't they? Okay, Zaid, let's go speak with him. I should be able to learn a little bit about him. One thing that I do have to say, I don't like how he doesn't talk a lot. I don't like that.
Hey, don't touch. That rifle's older than you are. I call it Jesse. That's my lucky charm. More men have been killed with that gun than died in the Skillion Blitz. The day I laid her to rest was the saddest day of my life. I'd give up every weapon I own for one more mission with that shitty old rifle. Oh yeah, that's a model of the Varrican. Turian frigate, hell of a ship. I led a mission to bring that thing down from the inside with just 5 men and whatever guns we could bring. No chance of success, but we did it. Everyone died.
That's crazy.
Impossible mission as an independent contractor. There's been many since, but nothing so goddamn sweet as watching that Turian warship crash planet side.
Speaking of man, he just went live. Shepard's got a pop in booty, yo. What is this? Are you wounded? No, I am actually doing like a cosplay for Shepard Commander. This is a little bit of a close-up. I have a black eye. Well, I drew on a black eye. But, yeah, I don't know if you can see it all. But we drew earlier on the stream. I like this side better. I think it's because I can see it. I can't see this side because my OBS is over on the other monitor.
Beauty, isn't it? Pride that of the Krogan warlord, Kazak. Used to run the blood pack out of Omega.
Oh, he's been still alive? Since I watched him yesterday?
Wasn't even a job.
He's crazy.
The guy just thought he'd hijack a freighter I was hitchhiking on. Big mistake. I goaded Kazak into one-on-one combat. Took out his legs, grabbed his gun, and killed every blood pack bastard in the room. That was the most beaten Krogan I've ever seen. Kept the helmet to remind me of that pained expression.
Dude, Zaid is such a badass. Yeah, for those of you who don't know about Man vs. Game, the longest stream that's ever been online other than... Well, I mean, Bob Ross doesn't count because those are pre-recorded, but... Man, the longest he streamed was 80 hours straight when he was playing Batman Arkham Knight. You fear for his health sometimes? Now, when I met Man... He was, like, really kind of, I wouldn't say frail, but he's very small. I mean, he looks small in his streams, but he wasn't smaller than Waffle, but he was definitely small. Like, Waffle was pretty skinny. Waffle was gangly. No, but, yeah, Man was... Didn't have much to grab. Eject the garbage. I could just keep doing this. He is super skinny. Yeah, he needs more meat on them bones. If you look at the picture of us together, like, my arm, like my, you can see my hand on the other side of him. He's so tiny. Sometimes I wonder if he wears his wrist, like the little wristbands that he wears, because he's just got really thin little, thin little wrists. I love how it just gets whisked in his face. Luna, I could sit there and just keep doing it. Okay, that's the core. That is where the calibrations happen. That's the living quarters, I think. That... Oh, okay, that's the map right there. This, I don't know. It's kind of hard to tell. Oh, there's a... Joker. Zaid, why do you have the surveillance in your room?
Thinking about past missions. Got a minute. You might learn something.
Yeah.
I was trying to remember how many Cerberus operatives I've killed. Lost track around 50. Guess your elusive man's big on forgiveness. Get a knife stuck in the right way. And you can pull that plate right off a Krogan's head. It's the best way to get a Krogan to talk. The threat of it drives him mad.
Thanks for the advice. Who do you think has the best booty in Mass Effect? Miranda. It's a scientific fact. She was engineered to be perfect. She was. Pathetic. Obvious answer is Miranda, but I think FemShep and Tali's is more than sufficient. Yeah, I mean, staring at FemShep's ass the entire playthrough is not too bad. It's not too bad. Let's go speak with Miranda. Yeah, Edie's... I like Edie's black suit better than her regular. But that's spoilers, because some... some viewers haven't seen it. But I guess it's not. I mean, it's kind of spoilers, but there's going to be spoilers. Miranda puts the ass in Mass Effect. Not saying Miranda is the only good ass, it's just the most globular. Gross. Globular.
How may I help you, Commander?
I have a present for you, Doc.
Ceres ice brandy? You didn't. Thank you. I always regretted not opening
She's
that original
my mom.
Bottle when I still could. I won't make the same mistake again. Why don't we open this bottle right here, right now, you and me?
The little Edie hologram is a great ass. Damn. It's like a globe. Oh, Miranda's ass. It is! It's like, whoop!
You crack open the bottle. I'll get the glasses.
Chakwa's face.
I thought Alenko's biotic display might have broken Jenkins' back, but Jenkins pops up and yells, "That was awesome!" Oh, Jenkins. Soldiers like him make the Alliance great. Cerberus lacks the same.
Wasn't Jenkins the first guy that died in Mass Effect? Tully is adorable. The arm? I think I missed it. Oh. No, that's not my arm. I just want to know if Terrians have external genitalia. I would guess they don't. Oh, Shepard's arm? Drunk Shep is best Shep.
With your service record, you could have gotten a tour of duty on any alliance.
He's his first sacrificial lamb.
Did you really leave?
Maybe it's less about
He went down like a bitch.
More about staying. As a military doctor, I mostly treat people who are in bad shape. Often they die.
He's like the first guy to die in any sci-fi.
They move on. Either way, they leave.
Don't you have any friends or family?
No, not lacking friendship.
Flowers are burning in his honor.
Stability.
Yeah, Jenkins went down so quick,
Jenkins
though.
Jenkins will always have Rolic syndrome. He would never admit it, but he needs my help, and he always will. I wish it weren't, but sadly, it's true.
How are you, Twilight?
The bastard who flies this ship.
Oh, yeah, I see the arm.
To ever take to the sky.
Her arm's the same, but you can't see it. Oh. Chakwa's arm. So we just drank the Joker. Whoa! Chakwas, that brandy. Oh, it's already worn off. How disappointing. Pretty sure there was a Jenkins in Halo who got wrecked by a flood.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Have you got any ideas for potential upgrades we could make?
White girl wasted.
Ideas, yeah. Yeah, take a look.
Okay, what do you have, ma'am? Seriously? Is that what she did? Advanced mineral scanner. Greatly speed up the planet scanning process, but I need 9,000 iridium. Dog is racked for the night. No emergencies. Take it away. You're bleeding out? Just done with it. Technically, yeah, Morden is the doctor. He'd probably be able to do something.
Whenever you have the time and resources, let me know.
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I'm just finishing an operation report. I'm impressed, Shepard. So far, things have gone exceptionally well.
As Cerberus operations go, this is one of the best I've been a part of.
She wants me to use it to scan her ass. Girl, bring that booty over here.
I'm glad you're enjoying it. Just remember who's in charge.
I know exactly who's in charge. I report to him regularly. I'm here, we're both here, because he wants it that way. Cerberus gave you a second chance, Commander. Maybe you should do the same for us.
Cerberus obviously has your loyalty. How did you get involved with them?
I suppose you've earned the right to know. Do you remember when I told you how I was genetically altered? Well, that wasn't my choice. My father created me. He's a very influential man and extremely controlling. He didn't want a daughter. He wanted a dynasty. I ran away as soon as I was old and brave enough. I went to Cerberus because I knew they could protect me.
How bad were the terms you and your father parted on?
Shots were fired.
Oh.
You seem capable of defending yourself. Why did you need Cerberus?
My father invested a great deal in his dynasty. It wasn't a matter of just leaving. I knew he would continue to pursue his investments.
I assume that Cerberus approves of your enhanced abilities?
Of course. Cerberus fully endorses anything that advances the cause of humanity. Genetic alterations included. But unlike my father and his own selfish reasons, Cerberus and the elusive man believe in a greater good. They see the bigger picture. And I feel like I have a purpose here.
My hips!
You told me a lot about your father.
She a test tube? What happened to your mother? Baby?
I never had one. Most of my genetic material is based on my father's tissue. His Y chromosome was altered with an amalgam of desired traits from various sources. How arrogant can you be? The man is completely egomaniacal. Just another reason I had to get away from him.
You talk about yourself like you're just a tool to be used by your father, by Cerberus.
Maybe. I like to know where I fit in the world. It helps me find meaning in how I was created.
All characters seem to have daddy issues in Mass Effect.
I need to make excuses for it.
That's easy for you.
Basically.
We've both been engineered for greatness, Shepard. The difference is you were great before we rebuilt you. I'm great because of it.
Oh, gosh.
Your spirit and personality are what make you great. It's what makes anyone great.
That's kind of you. I'm not sure I believe you, but thanks for saying it.
Who exactly is your father?
A businessman, but a very wealthy one. It's ironic. My father believed deeply in a human positive agenda. He donated generously to Cerberus before I joined them. That's how I first heard about Cerberus, through my father's connections.
Yo, that is interesting because we get the option of talking to Shepard's mom, but we don't get the option of talking to her dad.
Thanks for your time, Miranda. I'll talk to you later.
Anytime, Commander.
So I ordered a shirt off Teespring for Lyric cat hair. And it looks like it's gonna be too small. Oh, I thought he used American Apparel for his teacher drive, but I don't think that the shirt's American Apparel. It's just disappointing. Well, it made me think of that because this shirt is pretty thin itself. But I still like this shirt. I'm gonna probably order some things off of Bioware Store. For those of you who don't know, for N7 weekend, there's a 20% off over at the Bioware store for merchandise. We already have his stuff. Shep's dad is never mentioned. Only in, like, the background, that's it. Ah, oh, Liara. So did you know if you romance someone in this, this game, she'll put the picture down of your romance from the first one? Okay, Simmer, thank you very much for stopping by. Thank you very much. And, enjoy the evening. I know it's almost midnight my time. But, have a great night, Simmer. I hope to see you again soon. And I know I'll talk with you on the Twitter. So loud. Always buy your t-shirt or your shirts one size bigger from BioRestore. I'm wearing the old Caden boyfriend long sleeve jersey. Ooh, you know, that's actually a good suggestion. I have this t-shirt, and then I also have one of the hoodies that zips up vertically. Obviously, no, it's diagonally. And it's a little bit tight, but if it was any bigger, it would be too long in the arms. Most female fit clothes are super tight. Mm. That's when we went to when we went to TwitchCon and we got their clothes, I got the men's. Oh, this music. This is the music when you first go to the Citadel. We need to go to the Citadel, but we're still on Omega. Oh, such beautiful. That's beautiful. Yeah, I need another drink. Give me just a second, guys. I'll be right back. I'm taking this with me, so I don't have to keep taking it on and off. But yeah, I'll be right back. Give me just a second. Rare parrot makes everything beautiful. Okay. Dude, this freaking black eye looks so cool. Plot twist, having space hamster is the only way to win. Space hamster, best hamster. Saren stands victorious over Shepard, then bam, space hamster slams into strength. What saves the day? Space hamster. Oh. Oh. yeah. Oh my gosh, I freaking love Rare Parrot. I mean, when I see the Rare Parrot, I have to keep staring at it. Let's see, I'm going to just tweet out, if I could control my phone, what we're doing. We're going to be going on and recruiting Archangel. I always want to say Archangel. Archangel. That'll take like an hour or so, maybe? For some reason, Saren auto-corrected to strength. Not even close. Go home, autocorrect. You're drunk. Archangel. It's not in 2 minutes for me. It's not going to be N70 anymore. Oh gosh, mine's trying to autocorrect me too. What accomplished. All your friends don't play the Mass Effect, so you're the only one to enjoy the hype today. The only people I was able to celebrate in 7 days with was you guys and Eric. You still have another 3 hours. Oh, so Paul, you're on the West Coast. Okay, back to Omega. Dude, I'm thirsty. I should've gotten water. Omega still looks like a jellyfish to me. The loading screens are a lot faster in Mass Effect than they were in Mass Effect 2. I feel like we still kind of wait for a while here. West side. What? Riv, you're on the west side too? Oh yeah, you said you're in California. It makes watching the stream much better because you guys actually know something about the game. Where I moved from in New York was like bumfuck nowhere. Ooh, maybe we should bring Morden with us. Nah, we'll bring Miranda. So they didn't know anything about anything up there. Like, we couldn't even talk to them about Reddit. Like, who hasn't heard of Reddit? But video games? Are you in Washington? It was nice to finally move someplace where I could talk to coworkers about video games. Although some of them still don't understand what I do. like the older, like my older coworkers try are like, what do you do? You stream video games? What does that mean? Snack time. I made cauliflower buffalo wings cauliflower buffalo wings, and I had to have one when I went down. You still don't understand Reddit, and I don't think I ever will. As a circle jerk, what I do is that I follow certain subreddits. That's all I do. I like got rid of all of like the top subreddits, the main subscribed ones, and I found my own. Like Mass Effect has its own. You could look up any game, any movie. It's got a subreddit for like everything. You managed to get two of your friends into Mass Effect. Tried to get my sister into Mass Effect, but that didn't happen. Cryoblast. Yeah. I thought I got 2 points. Oh, it was during the mission. Never mind. Yeah, we should be good.
Judging by the quarantine reports, the plague has been completely eradicated, Shepard. Dr. Solis's assistant has been helping any patients with complications. I have also accessed messages between mercenary groups regarding plans to deal with Archangel. There's a recruiting station at Afterlife that may have information on him.
That's so cool. You got one in front into the Witcher, so you're gonna try and shove Mass Effect into his face. Be like, you want to see this! You want to play this! Trying to slowly reel people in. Scientists love this type of game. Oh, I'm not surprised at all. Seems like a lot of scientists like spacey stuff. Plus, it has a lot of sciencey stuff, like the genophage. Okay, anything over here? No, that's where I go to actually go to Archangel's mission.
Come on, let me.
From now on, my criteria for new friends will be basic knowledge of Mass Effect. Hey, my name's John. Oh, hey, John, what's up? Have you heard of Mass Effect? No? Okay, sorry, I'm gonna walk away. Grizz.
Aria has a job she needs doing. You up for some work?
That depends on what Aria has in mind.
Aria's gotten word that some blood-packed mercs plan to kill an old acquaintance of hers, a Krogan named Patriarch. She'd like you to keep that from happening.
Yep.
What's the Blood Pack's problem with Patriarch?
If you've met Patriarch, you know. He can't keep his damn mouth shut. Some people don't appreciate his stories, especially when he dips into non-fiction.
What's Arya's interest in protecting him?
Patriarch was one of her deadliest enemies back in the old days. Now she keeps what's left of him around as a trophy. As long as he lives, he's a perfect example of what happens
Justin
when you go
McD7,
up against Arya.
Thank you very much for the follow. Welcome to the Morgan D.
Why come to me? Arya's usual muscle not up for the job?
Because Arya said so. What other reason do you need?
I have... Aren't persimmons a... No, they're a fruit. I've never had a persimmon. I must try a persimmon.
If Arya wants my help, she better tell me why. I'm not doing this for my health.
Fine. Whatever gets you to take the job. If it gets out that Arya's protecting Patriarch, well, that can look like a weakness. And some people might want to exploit that. You're not on her payroll, so you helping Patriarch just seems like a random act of kindness.
I'll look into it.
Good. Patriarch's downstairs, likely surrounded by his fans. Get him into hiding until the mercs move on. Come back
here. How do they know they don't have someone undercover? I'm rocking the cosplay. Thank you so much, Justin. have so much fun doing this. Earlier in the stream, that was the first thing we did, was the cosplay.
I'll be back when the job's done.
Good luck.
I'm the patriarch. Oh, he's downstairs. This is actually a quick mission. Why don't we just do this before Archangel? Real quick lack. I hate how it takes forever to get down there.
Investigators on Novaria have uncovered troubling data from the wreckage of Peak 15. Researchers there may have been cloning Rachni genetic material. Fortunately, according to Council representatives, the experiment produced no living Rachni. Alliance military.
That was the Rachni news. Peak 15, how they were on Novaria, and they found no, no Rachni left, because they were basically demolished. Dude, why would you have anyone in here?
Don't act like you know. Just plan for the funeral normally. No, you said he had close family. They'll just want revenge. Kill the family first. Then he'll get angry and come at you stupid. And then you kill him. I don't think I know you, human. I'm the patriarch. Arya's patriarch. What do you want?
Dude, whose voice is he? He sounds so familiar. Get that at work. Not the same, but looking at me like I'm talking a different language. You tried to explain to a group of friends about Mass Effect Andromeda, and they just looked at you and started to sing because they were all in a choir. That's great. Found a load of Mass Effect fans on Twitter, so I get all out of the system there. Yeah, Sim. There and here. The Mass Effect community on Twitch is a very good community to be a part of. Definitely. Oh, hey! Hey, boss, how are you?
Why do they call you Patriarch?
It's like an Asari matriarch, only male. It was Arya's little joke.
Is that Optimus Prime?
She let me down. She let me live. Kept me around as an advisor. And a trophy.
A Krogan as old as you must have some great stories.
I killed a lot of people, lived well, and was beaten by a small Asari who keeps me around as an example. My time is done. Anyone I killed is long forgotten.
I don't know, maybe it just sounds
stories
like him.
Are Arya's now.
I'm doing good, Cedric. Thanks very much for asking. Doing pretty good. Is that Optimus Prime's voice? I don't know. Sometimes he sounds like him, but sometimes he doesn't. Really close. All I can think of was like the narration for the Transformers movies. You been, behaving yourself, boss? I'm using my old chair again, because I can freaking do this. I can sit Indian style.
Rumor has it some people want you dead. Know anything about that?
Oh, I can think of a few. I know things. Old secrets, old grudges. A few floors you can dig up to find bodies underneath. Someone who wanted to weaken Arya might come after me. They do it to get to her, you see. Not for me. I don't matter enough anymore to have enemies of my own.
Oh, sad day.
What do you know about Arya?
A few centuries ago, Omega was my rock. When Arya arrived, she had nothing but the clothes on her back. I thought she was another dancer. She killed half my men and convinced the rest that she could run this place better than I did. She came for me here in this bar. We tore this place apart. She crushed one of my hearts, shattered half the bones of my body, and left me alive.
Jim Cummings. He's done a lot of Star Wars Rebels and Clone Wars and some Elder Scrolls. Oh, Elder Scrolls! Yes, I think that's exactly... His voice is very familiar, Justin. Jim Cummings. Is he Parthenax? He does Transformer voices, just not Optimus. Okay. Maybe he's not Parthenax. Oh, but thank you guys for looking that up. Jim Cummings. And thank you for tweeting out, Justin. I saw your tweet. Let me get that up real quick. He's Winnie the Pooh? Really? I love Winnie the Pooh. It's so stupid to say, but I do. Jim Cummings. Oh gosh. Darkwing Duck. Oh yeah, current voice for Winnie the Pooh and Tigger. Oh, he does sound like Tigger. Like if he didn't sound so evil.
Made her decide to leave you alive.
No, she doesn't destroy what she can use. She said I could have all my old comforts if I served as her advisor. I knew how things worked. I knew who to lean on, who to smack down, who to smile at. And everyone who respected me saw me beaten, broken. They knew that as strong as I'd been, she was stronger.
Some people want you dead. I've been asked to move you to safety.
Well, of course. Arya wouldn't want me hurt. It would make her
448? Wow. No, that's crazy. He's almost like a Laura Bailey.
Perhaps
or...
Arya's reputation is no longer my concern.
Troy Baker.
Perhaps I will stay.
Even Mark Hamill has a lot of voice.
Seems important enough to
voice
kill.
Acting.
You allow Arya to protect you
like
just
a few.
Pet? I thought you were a Krogan.
Arya let me live. She gave me a position of honor as her advisor.
She gave you a position of comfort as her trophy. Is that what you want? Or would you rather go down fighting?
I wished she'd killed me the day she beat me. That would have been a glorious death. But perhaps it is not too late to die well. Perhaps these assassins will remember my name. Farewell, human. And thank you.
She's gonna hate me for this. Oh gosh, Sim. Well, thank you very much for stopping by. Enjoy the rest of your night. Well, go to sleep. And then enjoy your day. Thank you very much, Sim. Thank you very much for stopping by. And happy N7 day! Which is past us. Oh, I think I got Paragon points for that.
Welcome to Afterlife. How may I serve you?
Pour me a drink. Hold the poison.
Oh, yes. I heard about my predecessor's little scheme. I'm very glad you survived. I've been instructed to give you drinks on the house. Rest assured that they will contain no illicit ingredients you haven't asked for.
Free drinks on the house!
How may I serve you?
I'll just have something to drink.
Of course.
Oh, 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 oh. Can we get it, Shep. Can we get her drunk?
Welcome to Afterlife. How may
I'll just have something to drink.
Give me all the drinks, buddy. I'm gonna name you Sammy. Sammy the Solarian bartender. Get wasted. Still have an hour and 45 minutes? Hour 45 minute hype?
I'll just have something to drink.
Of course.
I wish I could move as cool as Rare Parrot. Dude, yeah, that tiny ass bottle. He has to open up a piece.
Welcome to Afterlife.
Have something to drink.
Of course.
I have no smooth moves. I'm probably losing viewers because of this horrible dancing. Miranda's just like, can we get this shit over with? Dang, girl.
Welcome to Afterlife.
I'll just have
He's basically
to
like serving me okay. water. Nope. Shepherd is immune to alcohol, confirms. Who died there? Well, bang. Okay. Right, Thetis? Oots, 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 oots. Oh, she gonna hate me.
Arya wants to speak with you, human. Something about Patriarch taking on a squad of mercs by himself. I wouldn't keep her waiting.
I heard my old friend Patriarch died. Went out in a blaze of glory. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you? I gave him what you couldn't. A chance to die like a Krogan. That wasn't your decision to make. His life belonged to me. Patriarch was dead for centuries. You know that. How he was. I'd almost forgotten he was a Krogan.
Boots and cats and boots and
cats. You gave him the death he deserved.
Spend all my money on tips for the dancer.
Do you need something else?
Sex.
Thanks. Maybe I'll come back later. You should find a nice young man to keep you warm in the meantime.
I love in Mass Effect 3, like Shepard gets so drunk girl wasted. Arya is there. In Purgatory, I think that's the bar in Mass Effect 3. And she just sits on the couch. Shepard wakes up on the couch and looks over, and Arya's just like staring at her, like silent judgment. Come back later. Oh gosh. Metal Gear Solid hilarity.